Open Access for Responsible Research and Innovation is a way to become more responsible and in particular to develop a collective responsibility. So the different stakeholders that are the industries, the policymaker, educators, researchers and civil society would be able to share their responsibility.
I think open access is very important to innovate the research system because research becomes transparent and to stakeholders, so to researchers, but also to society.
When we talk about open access, we usually refer to scientific literature. As far as responsible research and innovation, we refer to a broader concept. We refer to a process of science democratization. What science democratization means is creating practice, institutions and tools in order to embed the principles of accessibility, accountability and transparency.
Open access is the culmination of the RRI process, if it is a process, in that we are making the results of our research available to people who are likely to be able to use it and use it effectively. We have a bunch of traditional audiences, companies, TTO offices, policymakers, but increasingly NGOs, civil society organizations are coming into the research arena, they're coming in, they're setting the research agenda, and we need to be able to facilitate those communities.
The mechanism of open access are very complicated, but dissemination of research is one of the main goals of research. So this is the way open access is innovating research in itself. For example, it is innovating peer review system. And this is because of open access and because of technology at the same time. It is not only open access, but open access is driven by technology.
With open access, there are of course practices which researchers already can identify with, and it's not a one thing which works for everyone in the same way, but you have to find your way, your own way, on how to share your research and your outcomes and work with others.
Yeah, I mean, for implementation, you need infrastructure, you need publishers who are willing to work with you. And there are, of course, lots of things out there. And then you have to decide on what is the way on how you would like to do it. I mean, the physics and the mathematics community, they will think about open access as an infrastructure where you can share your postprints, your preprints. And other research areas will think about, well, this is about books, can I do it for books? And others will say, okay, I have articles and I go to a journal. And maybe I also share my postprint on a platform.